Welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology video series. This video reviews the pathology of Giardiasis. Giardia is an extremely prevalent parasite and one of the most common causes of waterborne disease in the U.S. Giardia is most often contracted by drinking contaminated water or by consuming food irrigated with infective water. This is particularly the case with hikers who can easily become infected with the parasite by drinking directly from a stream or similar source. However, Giardia is most common in developing countries, where there are not proper sanitation protocols in place to remove the parasite. Those who have recently traveled to a developing country and have diarrhea symptoms have a 1 in 3 chance of being infected with Giardia. The parasite is also more frequently reported in children than adults in the U.S. This is due to the fact that children, particularly in daycare centers, are often in contact with feces via diapers and unclean surfaces, allowing the parasite to spread with ease. Giardia can spread via anal sex as well.
The infectious stage of Giardia is a cyst. Once inside of a host, these cysts open and produce 2 trophozoites. The trophozoites remove nutrients from the host, reproducing via binary fission. As they move towards the colon, they encyst, allowing themselves to be transmitted to other hosts. Giardia is also often associated with Helicobacter pylori. In cases in which H. pylori is eradicated, yet symptoms still persist, it is recommended to test for the presence of Giardia lamblia.
Some of the most common signs of Giardia is severe diarrhea, vomiting, abdominal cramps, and fever. This can be accompanied by anorexia, malaise, and fatigue. The parasite can cause chronic atrophic gastritis, the loss of glands in the stomach causing inflammation, and duodenal nodules as well. The cysts and trophozoites of the parasite can also be found in the stool and in the biopsy of an infected person.
The vast majority of Giardiasis cases present with normal histology, apart from the presence of cysts and trophozoites along the intestinal tract. Trophozoites are easily visible on slides with a characteristic falling leaf pattern. However, some cases have presented with atypical histologic changes. Villous blunting along the duodenum can be found, the villi becoming blunted or appearing atrophic when the lamina propria is infiltrated by macrophages. Increased inflammatory cells can also occur, but is not common nor a specific indicator of Giardia. The only guarantee of Giardia infection is the presence of cysts and/or trophozoites along the intestinal tract and in the stool. Macroscopically, Giardiasis typically appears to be normal tissue. Endoscopies do not typically reveal abnormal results. Despite this, Giardiasis, specifically chronic Giardiasis, can cause some macroscopic changes. Rarely, it can cause chronic atrophic gastritis or chronic inflammation of the gastric mucosa. It can also rarely lead to duodenal nodules and a decrease in epithelial resistance along the intestinal tract. Furthermore, Giardia can disturb bacteria in the gut, leading to irritable bowel syndrome. Less uncommon is inflammation and malabsorption and the associated macroscopic changes.
Giardiasis is typically treated with supportive care and antimicrobials in patients over 3 years old. Infections usually clear within 3 to 5 days. For children under 3, tinidazole or nitazoxanide are usually used for treatment.